start with solutions of first order linear differential equations. So these PPTs are available with you. I will use maximum my pen pad so that things will become clear to you. So today we will discuss first order linear differential equations. So first of all, I will write the general form of first order linear differential equation. और जहां आपको नहीं समझ आएगा प्लीज आस्क ए क्वेश्चन आई विल रिपीट डोंट वेट टिल द एंड ऑफ दिस लेक्चर यू कैन आस्क क्वेश्चन एट एनी टाइम सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विद द जनरल फॉर्म ऑफ फर्स्ट ऑर्डर लीनियर डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन सो वी विल स्टडी फर्स्ट ऑर्डर लीनियर डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन समटाइम रिटन एज LDE. So the general form of first order linear differential equation is dy by dx equal to px y equal to qx. Now you can see in this particular equation the order of this differential equation is 1 because dy by dx ka order kitna hai 1 hai second thing here no dependent variable is multiplied with independent variable even y comes at only one place so the transcendental functions will also not come in this particular equation so any equation which is written in this particular form is first order linear differential equation हाँ जी
आवाज कट हो जा रहा है
आवाज क्या कह रहे हैं
कट जाए बीच में सर
आवाज कट गया ये प्रॉब्लम सबको आ रही है आपको ही आ रही है एनी अदर स्टूडेंट हु इज फेसिंग दिस पर्टिकुलर प्रॉब्लम नो सर हमें
नहीं आ रही क्लियर आ रही है क्लियर आ रही
है
मे बी फॉर फ्यू स्टूडेंट इंटरनेट इज एन इश्यू आई थिंक फ्रॉम माय साइड थिंग्स आर क्लियर माय कनेक्शन इज गुड So again, I repeat you, the general form of first order linear differential equation is dy by dx plus pxy equal to qx. And we can clearly see here the order of the differential equation is only one. Moreover, no derivative and dependent variable are multiplied with each other. The terms px and qx, they are clearly the function of x, px. And qx are function of x only. They are the functions of x only. And such equations are named as Leibniz equation. They are named as Leibniz linear equations. So such equations are named as Leibniz linear equations. So I think now it is clear that what is the general form of first order linear equations, linear differential equations, and these equations are named as Leibniz linear equations. Now let us talk about how we can find the solution of these linear differential equations. So the next question is how we can find the solution of these linear differential equations. So now we'll talk about the solution of these equations. Solutions of linear differential equation of first order. I think you have already studied this type of equation. You are in plus two grade. I hope.
Yes, sir.
Yes. So now let us talk about how we can find the solution of the differential equation. To find the solution of the differential equation, what I will do, I will take a function ux. What I will do? I will take a function ux. Clearly, u is a function of x, and I multiply this with equation number 1. So let this be the our equation number 1. So what will happen? Ux dy by dx plus ux px y equal to ux qx. Ux qx. So this ux we have chosen. So we can choose this function ux such that this ux into px is basically u dash x. We have chosen this ux. We have chosen this ux such that this ux into px is equal to u dash x. So now what will happen? This means ux dy by dx plus u dash x y is equal to ux into qx. Now, any student tell me what will happen with this? What is the benefit to do this? Anybody who can answer? Or tell me this differential, this part is equivalent to which? Anybody? आप लोगों ने प्लस टू में पढ़ा ही है. This term is
d u x.
Yes.
Differential of u x and y. Multiplication
one. Yes. Excellent. Very good. So this expression will become d by dx of u x into y. So if you apply the multiplication rule here, what you will get? Ux into derivative y, that is dy by dx, plus then the derivative of ux, which is equal to u dash x into y. So now from here, what we can do? We can rewrite it as d of ux into y equal to ux qx into dx. So what we can do, we can integrate both sides, and as we integrate both sides, what will happen? What we will get? We'll get ux,
ux
is equal to integral of ux into qx into dx plus some arbitrary constant c. So, in this equation, you can see that this equation is free from derivatives. Here, no derivative term is involved. So, this is the solution of the given linear differential equation. But, yes, we have one problem. What is the problem? We don't know about this ux. This ux we have chosen. We know about the value of qx, but we don't know about the ux. So the next is how we can find the value of ux. So here, from here, we can find the value of ux. So what is ux from here? Ux is basically u dash x upon ux equal to px. इज इट करेक्ट करेक्ट वी कैन रीराइट लाइक दिस लिख सकते हैं ऐसे ऐसे
यस सर
यस तो व्हाट वी गेट u dash x on ux equal to px now if I integrate this equation what we will get what is the derivative integration of this integration of it is log of ux equal to integral of px and we need not to write the constant c here because we will put the value of ux in this particular equation and here the term u here the term c is already presented so need not to write c again and again so from here we get log ux equal to integral of px so from here what we can write ux is equal to e raised to power integral of px sorry here dx also come so integral of px into dx and this term is named as integration factor this is named as
integration
factor so this is your integration factor so from here what we can conclude that the solution of a first order linear differential equation is given as y into integration factor equal to integral of qx into integration factor into dx plus some constant c and integration factor is given by integration factor is e raised to power integral of pdx so jab aapne isko plus 2 mein padha tha when you have studied this topic in plus 2 you have just learned this expression the solution of first order linear differential equation is given by y into integration factor equal to integral qx into integration factor dx plus some constant c so today we will see we see how we can find the solution of the general form of first order linear differential equation any doubt till now kisne kuch puchna ho isme anybody any student any doubt aisa to nahi uska sabko samajh aa gaya ho
aur samajh aa gaya
haan ji thoda uncha bolo mujhe ye samajh nahi aaya ki aapko samajh aaya ya samajh nahi aaya mujhe isme confusion hai samajh aa gaya nahi aaya
yes sir
nahi aaya koi baat nahi let's repeat once again so we started with a general form of first order linear differential equation that is dy by dx plus pxy equal to qx px and qx are the functions of x only and these equations are named as Leibniz linear equations to find the solution of this differential equation we take a function of u ux we take any function ux and we multiply this ux with the whole expression so we get ux into dy by dx plus ux pxy equal to ux into qx since we have chosen ux ourselves what we can do we can put a condition on ux and we put the condition on ux that ux is such that ux into px equal to u dash x or u dash x divided by ux equal to px one not the same thing and when we then this equation can be rewritten as this and here this part is basically d by dx of ux into y and if we integrate both side what we will get ux into y equal to integral of ux qx into dx plus some constant c. As this equation is free from the derivative, we can say this is a solution of the given differential equation. Moreover, the problem is, now the problem is, this ux is unknown to us. We assume the value of this ux. So we use that expression that u dash x upon ux equal to px dx. We integrate both sides and we find that log of ux is equal to integral of px dx, and from here ux is equal to e raised to power integral of px dx. And finally, you can conclude that the solution of differential equation is given by this particular expression. Page here. Take a problem and solve it. Now, let the question is, solve the differential equation 1 minus x square dy by dx minus xy equal to 1. So the first purpose will be to convert this linear differential equation into a Leibniz form of this question. So the first thing which we have to do, we have to put this particular equation into a Leibniz form. That Leibniz form is dy by dx pxy equal to qx. So first of all, we'll try to put the given differential equation, this differential equation, into this form. So what we'll do, we'll rewrite this equation as dy by dx minus x upon 1 minus x square y 1 minus x square. So from here, we can say that this is our px and this is our qx. So to solve a differential equation, the first thing which we require is integration factor. So first of all, we will find the integration factor. Integration factor is given by e raised to power integral of px dx, or e raised to power, now what is px? Px is minus x 1 plus x square dx. Because you can see here the term is plus. So when you take px from here, it will be minus x upon integral of minus x upon 1 plus x square dx. So let's solve this integral first. So this is just simple, but for the few students who are not comfortable with integration, let I may solve this integral. So this is minus sign x 1 plus x square. It's 1 plus x square or 1 minus x square? It's 1 minus x square.
So it's minus, sir.
It's minus. So it's minus. It's minus. So it's dx. So what we will do, we will take t equal to 1 minus x square. So what is dt? Dt will be minus 2x into dx. So let me write clean. So, if we put these values above, what we will get? Now, what is x into dx? That is minus dt by 2. So, it will become 1 by 2 dt divided by t. So, it will be 1 by 2 log. Is it clear to all?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
And we know that in log, we can take it इनसाइड आल्सो। पता है सब लोगों को ये, जो भी चीज मल्टीप्लाई में होती है वी कैन टेक इट टू द पावर।
यस सर।
सो अगेन इट मींस दिस इंटीग्रेशन फैक्टर इज e रेज टू पावर log of t raised to power 1 by 2. So from here e and log will cancel each other, you will get t raised to power 1 by 2, which is basically under root. What is the value of t? T is
1
minus x
square.
So you find the integration factor. Now let's write down the solution. How we can write a solution? Solution is given by y into integration factor equal to integral of q integration factor into dx. Now what is integration factor? Y into under root 1 minus x. Now what is the value of q? Q is
1 upon 1 minus x square.
So this is basically 1 upon 1 minus x square into under root 1 minus x square into dx plus some constant c. So this comes to be 1 upon under root 1 minus x square dx plus c, which is basically sine inverse x plus some constant c. So the solution is given by y into under root 1 minus x square sine inverse x plus c. So this expression will give the solution of the differential equation. So I hope this is clear to you now.